In this tutorial, I'll show you how to fuse two different meshes into one. I'll also show how to use the loop tool's loft to fuse to connect multiple meshes as well. Let's create a plane. Shift D to duplicate, and type Z to move it up like this. The method I'll be using is going to be the bridge edge loop method. In order to make that work, we must join two meshes together. If we don't join them, the bridge edge loops won't work. Another rule to follow is how we must have matching number of vertices on both meshes. In object mode, select both planes and press Ctrl, J to join them. In edit mode, bridge edge loops to join them. This will work no matter how the second mesh is placed. Let's remove the top plane and add a cylinder. If we don't have matching number of vertices, we'll end up with a mesh that have less or more than 4 number of vertices on the faces. (32) vertices on the cylinder and 4 vertices on the plane. That worked, but now we have a bunch of triangular faces. If we subdivide it, things wouldn't look as good as when they were quads. Let's remove the cylinder, and create one with 8 vertices at the bottom. Select the plane. Right-click and type S to subdivide. We'll have 8 vertices that way. Please don't add too much details, otherwise the n-gon issue will occur again. Once we have a matching number of vertices, we can bridge edge loop. If we subdivide this mesh, everything will look smooth. What if the cylinder was rotated before joining them? That will still work, but we might need to add some additional details to make it look good. Ctrl R to add a loop cut. Please use mouse wheel up to add more segments. Now we can proportionally move the connecting edge loop forward to make it look better. Let's add some inner extrude and loop cuts to make this look better. The only N-gon we have on the mesh is the bottom face. This was how to use the bridge edge loops feature. Let's take a look at the loop tools method. I'll duplicate and rotate multiple faces and join them together. In edit mode, right-click and select loft under loop tools. If you don't see that, please activate the loop tools add-on. The loft will allow us to join multiple meshes at the same time. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.